life is nothing more than a logical, linear, predictable machine. The belief that I have determination over the person I am and the person I will become is fraudulent. Dominic Schellingford, the name to which I identify with more than anything that exists, is not mine. It was given to me, like so much. It is purely an inheritance, but I am obliged to take ownership of it. As with my name, I have inherited all that is the product of my genetics. My skin color, my height, my gender, the color of my eyes, the shape of my nose, the tone of my voice, the way I walk, the hand I write with, are not of my choosing but is simply an inheritance. It has all been woven into me from conception, revealing itself more and more each day. Everything people see when they look at me is not of my own volition. Everything I exist as in the physical world is nothing more than an inheritance. My inevitable procession to mimic the mannerisms and appearance of my dad grows stronger and stronger each day, as he also did with his dad. I received the adulation for running quickly. Did I control how fast I was able to run? The characteristic of running quickly, like every other physical characteristic, can only be derived from my genetics. Should I have been intrinsically rewarded for having fast parents? What is the greater cause of my victory? Me, or my cumulative procession of athletic ancestors? All human beings with our joint genealogy display shared behavior. We jointly display precise facial expression to specific stimuli not because we choose to, but because we are all compelled to. We are programmed to use language, to understand our environment, to advance. All life is internally governed to survive, to avoid hunger, to avoid death, to procreate, not through our choosing but through the advisement of our collective design. We cannot escape our doctrine. A bird does not choose to migrate. A dog does not choose to retrieve a stick. We are nothing more than animals. Our intelligence does not elevate us above this tenet but only serves to demonstrate our status within it. We do not choose to create weapons, to appreciate music, to be wary of difference, to seek understanding, to attain happiness or to be aroused by beauty. They are innate within us. We are programmed to behave in the way we do. It is not a choice, it is merely the translation of our design. I can be nothing more than the genetics I inherited or the product of my experience. That wonderful discussion, nature versus nurture, excludes me. I am no more in control of my genetic makeup as I am of the world to which I have been nurtured. I simply respond as Dominic Schellingford responds. My genetic code is indelibly intertwined with my experiences, how I was brought up by my parents, entertained by the media, treated by my siblings, taught by my schools, interacted with my friends and enveloped within my society. The language and accent I speak with, my view of the world and my place within it, my morality, my happiness, my intelligence, my confidence, are all irrefutably fused with everything that exists outside of my own psyche. The genetics that prescribe the color of my eyes also prescribes the exact way I will react and respond to every moment of my existence. It is this accumulation of responses to my environment that formulates the person I am and the personality I am identified by. I am no more than a car is, or any piece of technology. As a car, I am not independent. My specification has been the creation of designers, defining how I look and how I behave. I am driven, controlled by a driver. If the steering wheel is turned anti-clockwise, as a result of my design, I have no choice but to turn left. If a brake is pushed, I am obliged through my design to carry out the order to restrict my wheels. Every stimulus I experience in the real world, applied by my environment, translates through my design and produces the prescribed, and my only possible response, obeying exactly as a mechanical object would. If the car were given consciousness, surely even it would understand that it was merely responding to external stimuli, and not affecting them itself. The opinions you are now invariably formulating in response to what you are seeing and hearing in this video are inevitable to you at this time. You have not chosen your response, it has simply been arrived at. In 45 seconds you will be shown an image, to which you can only have one response, infinitely specific to you and only you. The image is set, it cannot be changed. However, the person you are now is different to the person you'll be in 30 seconds. If you were to have viewed the image yesterday, your opinion would have been different as it would be if the image were shown now. Your brain is constantly changing, interpreting, experiencing, listening to these words, anticipating. The image may show a horrific scene or something mundane and anticlimactic. Whatever you're feeling, repulsion or disappointment, you will have no control over it. Did you decide your response? Could you have reacted in a different way? If I had replaced the image, your opinion of this video would be different, not through your choice, but through mine. You respond in this way millions of times a second. Your brain is constantly interpreting and giving you your answer. Likewise, it is not your decision to find this style of music appealing. It is obvious that personalities have to be very structured and binding. Otherwise, they would fail to be personalities, but would only exist as a mass of homogenized, generic thought, reacting randomly and without precedent. Just as two distinctly shaped glasses containing water when smashed will cause the water to form two generic puddles on the floor. Without the structured container to which we are bound, we would cease to be anything of any character or inimitability. Humans, animals and life have to be severely inimitable. This linearity extends not only to your responses but also to your decisions. Consider an important decision you have made in your life, like an acceptance of marriage. Saying yes was not simply a whimsical 50-50 choice that could be taken in isolation from the rest of your life. It is actually the result of every thought, feeling, aspiration and situation you had made or were subjected to, no matter how subtle or subconscious, leading up to the exact moment you knew how you were going to respond. If you were placed back in that scenario an infinite number of times, at exactly the same instance, your resultant response would always be yes. As every other moment in your life would be identical up to that point, it would be impossible for your answer to be contrary. If your answer could only ever have been yes at that time, free will cannot exist. Life does not differ from a precession of falling dominoes, each fall directly affecting the next, which in turn affects the next, each moment of time leading on to the inevitable next moment of time. The simple propagation of a chain reaction. Since the beginning of time, everyone and everything has adhered absolutely to a linear path, from the life of an ant to the orbits of planets. Existence is relentlessly linear. You cannot escape who you are, where you are, or the product of these two inputs. Everything within this universe is required to follow predictable laws, both animate and inanimate objects. The actions of inanimate objects are also controlled, with scientific rules giving structure and personality to otherwise isolated, benign objects, allowing for total predictability. Imagine a simple experiment in which a lever can be cranked backwards and a coin placed on the end of the arm. When the lever is released, it propels the coin forwards. It is likely that if this experiment were repeated several times, the results would vary due to the many variables that act on the lever arm and on the coin throughout the experiment. These variations would range from the force of the lever arm, the size, position and weight of the coin, air disturbances, temperature and humidity, gravity, the surface on which the coin would land. If these are the reasons for the disparity between action and consequence, then what would happen if you could unify them all? If the experiment were repeated with identical variables, the results of the experiment could be nothing other than identical, with the coin landing on the same side every time. However, more crucially, the coin would also spend exactly the same amount of time in the air, will complete the same amount of revolutions, would impact the floor with precisely the same force and would come to rest in exactly the same place every time the experiment was conducted. In other words, at that time there could only have ever been one infinitely precise outcome to the experiment. An apparently random act is nothing more than a predictable maths problem. This unswerving predictability is entrenched in every moment of time that passes. Just as the outcome of any moment is predetermined, so too will the next moment of time lead on to the next knowable outcome. One moment of time cannot lead on to the equal likelihood of two different outcomes occurring. God is not gripped by the twists and turns of your life, as a director is not surprised by the twists at the end of his film. An omnipotent God would be fully aware of the last moment of time and all intervening moments since the creation of our universe. Since existence's first fateful steps were initiated, there could only have ever been one outcome. If you were to exactly and identically repeat the first moment of our universe, the fate we have all witnessed throughout history and will continue to witness will be identical. From the conversation you had yesterday, to your views of the statement now. If you were capable of knowing all the prerequisites needed to enable a future outcome, the future would become predictable. For this not to be the case, life would make no sense, there would be no logic or structure on which to exist. We do not live in a world where 2 plus 2 sometimes equals 7, and we do not live in a world where variation happens with no cause or contribution. We are all simply characters in a book that was written 14 billion years ago, compelled to read our lines and act as we should. Every day that passes is simply the turning of a page and a step closer to the storyline's conclusion. This is God's floor.
Dumb one.